I like men. I'm a very blessed man. I realize I've got great children, man. My kids are great. I've got a doctor in the family. I've got an engineer in the family. I've got three boys and three girls and two boys. And I tell people this all the time, right? If anybody in this audience has both boys and girls, you must realize one thing, right? You cannot raise them the same way. You cannot talk to them the same way. You cannot logic and reason with them the same way. You cannot discipline them the same way because they're two different animals, all right? Little boys between the ages of 8 and 22 are possibly the slowest creatures on this planet. You ask a little boy 8 years old a simple question, how was school? It was good. You got homework? I don't know. So I always encourage my kids, you know, ask questions. Ask. Knowledge is power. So get out there and ask, right? So I'm in the yard one day cutting the grass. My son walks up. He goes, Dad, I got a question. I said, great, son, what's the question? He said, look, we don't have a fence. Why does our dog never leave the yard? I said, great question, son. Here's why. We have a thing called an invisible fence, right? Dog wears a collar. Things in the ground. Dog walk close. Give the dog a little shot. Right? Then at one point, the dog's going to go, you know what? Evidently, I'm going the wrong way. That's what the dog's going to say, all right? Now, you cannot explain anything as clear and as simple as I did to my son that day. At 11 years old, my son did not comprehend what I told him. So this kid decided he wanted to try the collar for himself. Now, as a parent, you would normally say, don't do that. I said, go ahead, son, put it on. And he printed and said, Dad, watch this. So you don't have to tell me to watch. I've been waiting on this for 8 years. Go ahead. Run, son, run! And he's running, hey, Dad! And he fell on the ground, he was shaking. I don't want to touch him, so I got a stick. Are you all right? Are you all right? And the dog was standing right there. That boy's an idiot. Look at that boy there. I did that 5 times yesterday. There's something wrong with that boy. Little boys are like that, man. Little boys are slow like that. Little boys never change. Now, girls, they go through different stages, all right? Now, when they're young, they go through the stage where they like to talk a lot, all the time. All the time. They never, ever, ever shut up, as cute as they are. And I love my daughters at that age because they were so cute. You know, they're 6 to 8 range right there, the 5, 6, 7, 8 range right there. The clothes they wore, the pink outfits and the ribbons and the flip-flops and all this kind of stuff, and the blue bears and the pink bears and all that kind of, and they were so cute. But they never, ever shut up. Hey, baby, how was your day? And then Mary says, then they get a little bit older. Then they get about 12 or 13 years old, and then everything becomes the end of the world. Anything that goes wrong is the end of the world to them. It's so dramatic. It's traumatizing for life. Life as we know it, Dad, is over, right? So I'm in my room right here. My daughter's room right here in between the staircase, all right? So I'm watching a football game. I hear my daughter in her room start to cry. So this goes on for like an hour, all right? So at that point, I did what any concerned parent would do. I got up and closed the door. Because it was going on my nerve. I'm trying to watch the football game. That's more important. Because I know it's something I don't want to be involved in. I know it's not going to make any sense. I know it's going to be mad, all right? And so I'm thinking to myself, another hour goes by. I said, you know what? I'm going to go downstairs, get a snack, the staircase right there. She'll never see me because her room, you can't see the staircase. So boys and girls, I start my journey. First step, good. Second step, good. I forgot the third step in my own house. I forget that third step makes a little noise when you hit it. And I stepped on it. I was like, ah. And sure enough, my daughter, Dad. Dad, is that you, Dad? I said, yes, baby. I was just coming to check on you. Because I heard you crying, right? And I knew it was going to be something stupid, right? So I walk in there, baby, what's going on? She said, Dad, I can't believe it happened to me. I said, what did she say? Maybe I can't tell you. I said, okay, I'll come back. Wait a minute, hold on. Maybe I can tell you. I said, what is? She said, Dad, you won't believe it. I said, I'll never know. What's the problem? She said, Dad, I can't find my other sock. I went downstairs and got the shock collar from my son. They're great, though, man. Like I said, I'm very blessed, man. Beautiful children. They are gorgeous. I don't say because I'm their father. They are gorgeous, though. They're mixed. They're mixed kids. Because my ex-wife is from hell. Because my kids are half black and half possessed. I don't know what happened. Walking in the house, how you doing, son? That's some of your mama's rings. So my son now, he's grown. My son's 31 years old, so he wants to have these talks, you know, about life and everything, right? So he came one day and said, hey, Dad, what happened with you and Mom? I said, look, let's talk about it, because it might help you in the future with your own relationship. I said, here's what happened. When I first met your mom, I just overlooked a lot of things you should never overlook. He said, like what? I said, when I first met your mom, she had no reflection. That should have been a sign right there. Every picture of my wedding, I'm all around nobody, just standing by myself, just. I'm just saying, here's the thing, right? Kids are bad because it's our fault, not their fault, and here's why, all right? We give our kids too many things, all right? We spoil them too much. The more they get, the less they appreciate. That's the problem right there, all right? You gotta start giving gifts to your kids like my father gave to me, all right? For my 9th birthday, my father gave me a bike, all right? For my 10th birthday, he gave me the front tire. Now, that's how you give a gift. By the time I got assembled, I was 27 years old. I couldn't even ride a thing. And I believe this, right? There's only two kind of moms in the whole world, two, all right? There's a good mom and a violent mom. You ever see a mom get so mad at their children when they talk to them, their teeth don't move, just the lips go up and down? You ever seen those moms? Put it down, put it down, put it down. I will choke you right now. When you put that back on the shelf and you get yourself back over here. That's the good mom. I had the violent mom. My mom was the kind of woman that would hit me first and then say, put it down. Let's walk up out of nowhere. Bam! Now put that down.